Hi guys, this is Benchfiddler. Today I'm going to play a song from the very first album of Lindsey Stirling, Spontaneous Me, which is a pretty difficult song, so after the cover I will do a little tutorial for this song and I hope it can be of any use to you. Music! Okay, so now let's have a little tutorial for this song, which is pretty difficult. So the beginning is technically more simple. But you still have to practice each note separately so that it's perfectly in tune and play with the metronome because the rhythm is a little offset. There begins the difficulty. Because this song has many parts in 16th notes and played very fast. Best thing to do first is to practice them slowly with the metronome again. Could mark the beats on the score to help you. And also when you practice, mark the beats as you play. is difficult is that these bees are played down up and then up down. So you can use rhythms, different rhythm patterns. Then like this. You can also practice the phrase playing loudly the bees and playing the rest of the phrase lower. Because the important notes here are the bees. They have accents on them. Your left hand doesn't have a lot of work to do. You're in first position. You just use the second and third fingers. And then you stay, you just put the fourth finger. The sharp F is just next to your B. So don't panic. So this is one of the most difficult phrases of this song. You have to master it no matter what. So play it slowly with rhythms. Also practice with a pause between each group of four 16th notes. Prepare. Then 8 16th notes all together. And then all together. Do it several times, practice it again and again because it's not easy. You can also sing the phrase with the notes names, and then when you play it, think of the notes names. If you can think of all the notes names at the same time you play them, it becomes much easier. So this part is also pretty difficult, but you can find a way to make it easier. You can practice it with the same technique we used for the precedent phrase. Also with the left hand. It's all in first position. You use open strings, so it's easier. The end of the phrase is important because it must have an impulse. And with the A open string, you shift to third position. It will sound better and you can vibrate your E better. With a nice decrescendo. Afterwards, this is hard too. All the notes are linked, so you can practice them separately, but also with rhythm patterns like before. Also with separate hands. First, play with the left hand alone. Then with the right hand alone. Then both hands. The important thing here is to be regular, to be steady. Here too you can mark the beats to help you find your marks. This is hard too. And you have to put accents on the Fs. This can actually help you. If you concentrate on the Fs and play the other notes lower. Also, here you can also practice each hand separately. And then the right hand. Marking the accents. Then two hands together. Then you will do it much easier. So these double stops. They're not as hard as they appear. It's all in first position, and the key is to, when you play the E just before the double stops measure, you keep your first finger on the board. You don't move it, you keep it there. Now the B, you have to practice your B so that this fourth sounds good. After that, it's easier. You don't move. After that, you have the G just next to your second finger. Lift them and put them again in the same place. The B is just the next string, the A string. So just move slowly to have your finger on both strings. You have to put them again. Then you put your fourth finger in tune. So you have to practice these double stops so that your finger make the fewest moves. The most simple possible. Thank you. position. So now it's like the climax of the song, so you have to play forte and vibrate the B's. If you can, shift to third position to vibrate better. Go back to first position at the G. So, same thing, these double stops are pretty simple for the left hand. You just keep your first finger in first position in the D and A strings to have this fifth. And then you keep it on the board. You just put the second finger to play the C. The important notes are of course the double stops. The E's are just filler notes, so you can play them lower. First, just play the double stops. Then all the notes with the single E's lower. After that, it's still in first position. You have to use the third finger to play the D. And for the sharp F, do an extension. Because you don't have time to shift to third position. So this is a very nice part of the song, because it's cantabile sostenuto, which means with a singing and sustained voice. And the second part of this phrase can sound a little different, because the accompaniment itself changes too at this time. So you can play with no vibrato, with like a dreamy effect. Make a harmonic for the last A, it will sound better. You can also play sub ponticello, which means close to the bridge. It will make another nice sound effect. So for the whole song, practice slowly with the metronome. Each note must be in tune. When you practice slowly with the metronome, it's easier for each note to be in tune. And as you increase the speed, you have to stay in tune also. So whatever technique you use, this always will mean practicing. Use different rhythm patterns. Practice each hand separately, then both hands. Do not neglect the slow parts of this song, because they are very important, they are beautiful, they have to be played well in tune and with expression. Once you can play this song, other song may seem simpler to you, because this is, in my opinion, one of the technically hardest songs of Lindsey Stirling. Also practice your position shifting on the board. You just have to use first and third position in this song, and your position shiftings must be smooth. And then the rest of the song is pretty much the same thing as what we practiced so far. So if you can play this song up to this point, you're good to go. Alright, that's it for this tutorial. I hope you liked it. I hope you found it useful. Please tell me in the comments if you liked it and what I should do next, what cover I should do next, what tutorial, another Lindsey Stirling song or any other violin piece. I played using the official backing track of this song and sheet music. So please don't ask me for the backing track or sheet music, as you can get your own from Lindsey Stirling's website. My upcoming video will be a cover of Lindsey Stirling's latest song, Underground, and most likely a tutorial too. I will make this video as soon as the official backing track of Underground is available, so stay tuned. Please like if you did and subscribe, and have fun playing.